Hello and welcome back to Proactive. I'm delighted to be joined on the line now by Brian Haugli, who is, of course, the CEO of SideChannel. Brian, thank you very much for joining us. And for those not already familiar with SideChannel, could you tell us a bit about the business?
Yeah, no, thanks for having me. We are primarily focused on building cybersecurity programs for mid-market companies and startups. And we draw on our experiences from the enterprise space where many of us have come from as the chief information security officer. So think about when you have the CFO sitting in the spot, driving the financials, driving the strategy around that side of the house. The chief information security officer is the person driving the cybersecurity, the risk management, possibly the privacy program. We draw on that. We're bringing that into a very underserved market that is the what's known as the mid-market, specifically within the United States, as well as startups.
Understood. So what was it that first alerted you to this gap in the market?
So I previously have been the lead for security programs, both within the Department of Defense in the US, as well as the CISO, the Chief Information Security Officer, at a Fortune 500. And having been in these enterprise and large scale organizations, relying quite a bit on the mid-market companies and smaller businesses, I always saw there was never someone like me that I could dialogue with at those vendors, at those other providers. And that worried me because I was now reliant on really them to provide services, but now I'm also reliant on extending my security posture out to them. So I need to make sure that they're secure. And that was really the kind of the first inkling that there was a lack of expertise at a senior leadership level. There was a lack of the right types of products and other services that the mid-market could both afford and implement. So that really kind of birthed the whole idea of SideChannel and brought us through when we launched in 2019. And we've been growing. We've been growing ever since, focusing on this space.
It's a fascinating story. So you're around about 3 years into the journey. What do you think you're most proud of so far?
Well, I think our ability to attract the talent that we've brought on. We have former CISOs from companies and organizations that are much, much larger than our clients. And, you know, companies like Best Buy, Dick's Sporting Goods, to kind of look at retail. We've had folks come from Broadcom and other large IT providers, even other large security providers who were trying to look at this space, but now want a better way and a better focus on making cybersecurity simple and accessible for clients. So our ability to attract talent has been something I'm very proud of. I think we have a great culture and inside of our team. Everyone sees each other as peers. No person is a lone man on an island, really. So that makes for great retention and a great customer, and then translates to a really happy customer base. But I think our on the product side, it's been very interesting. We have this willing client base that's showing us their problems and telling us what they're willing to purchase. And we're building those products now for them. And I find that it's a great partnership between the client who's willingly telling us what they want us to sell them. And we're solving real problems. It's not just a new shiny object that a lot of security seems to kind of fall victim to. You know, what's the latest and the great? We're trying to solve problems that maybe aren't as sexy as some of the stuff that's, you know, high profile on the sales side. And instead, you know, we're fixing the things that are actually creating real risk, and we're removing that risk.
It sounds like you're very well set, but obviously, like any business, you must face certain challenges. So what challenges have you been dealing with so far?
So it's been interesting. We launched prior to the pandemic, and we weathered that very easily, mostly because we're a remotely native company. We don't have while I sit in our headquarters, it's a small office, but we're all across the US and all across Canada. So we've been able to, you know, navigate the remote work lifestyle quite well. And then now looking at a possible recession, especially within the United States, it's been interesting that we are the solution kind of in these hard times where you can't afford someone like me to be full time. You can't afford some of the products that are predominantly enterprise, you know, focused. People are looking to, you know, kind of strain, they're straining their budgets. They're bringing back their costs, or they're trying to get their costs under control. We become the obvious solution because we are fractional on our services and our delivery. Our products are purpose-built financially and from an implementation standpoint to the mid-market so that they can afford them. So it's been it's been great to kind of take the challenges that the world's kind of going through and really use them as our superpower.
Well, let's see how it all pans out. I would just have one final question for you, Brian. Where do you think the company is going to be in a year's time?
I think our ability to deliver is going to continue to grow. We've seen that the last 3 years. I have no inclination of seeing that change, especially with the markets of the way that they are. I think what you'll see us do is really kind of grow more to what is the program that cybersecurity you need as a company. And SideChannel, with its depth and its talent, how are we the ones who are the best set to provide that to you? So you're going to see us maybe move a little bit upstream in market towards smaller enterprises. But you're really going to see, I think, more of a programmatic deployment to see more products round out really our full delivery.
Lovely stuff. Brian Haugli, the CEO of SideChannel, thank you very much for joining us on Proactive.
Thank you.